Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Sutter Health Park for our graduation ceremony for the C.K. McClatchy Class of 2023. I'd like to welcome the McClatchy AFROTC Color Guard, who will present the colors, followed by Senior Maddie Flint, who will sing the national anthem. Please stand and remove your hats.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the pale rollers fight? O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you, cadets and Maddie. What a beautiful rendition and a great start to the ceremony. Let's give them both another quick hand. Amazing job, great start. I'd like to welcome our salutatorian, Adelaide Orr. She'll be reading a guest decorum statement.
Good morning. Welcome to McClatchy High School's 2023 commencement ceremony. I'm Adelaide Orr, and I'm McClatchy's salutatorian. McClatchy has a long tradition of distinguished graduation ceremonies, and we expect today's 86th commencement will be no exception. The class of 2023 has worked hard and is excited to be here today to celebrate this important life milestone with all of you. As such, we want to remind our guests that this is a dignified and momentous ceremony, and we ask that you behave in accordance with the tone of this event. As the audience, you are an important part of today's ceremony. The audience's responsibility at graduation is to honor the graduates' efforts by providing an atmosphere where all the students can appreciate their special moment of acknowledgement. To that end, we ask for your cooperation in the following. Please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. Electronic devices such as cell phones create unwanted noise. Please remain seated and quiet while the speaker portion of the ceremony is in progress. If it becomes necessary to leave your seat, please do so between speeches or performances. Please treat all speakers and performers respectfully. They prepared for today's event and are owed your undivided attention and courtesy. If young children become restless and disrupt others' listening ability, please escort them to the concourse. Please keep umbrellas and other items from obstructing the view of others around you so all guests can see a professional program and presentation of graduates. Please remain seated while your grad crosses the stage and do not enter the aisle or come forward to take pictures. Photos of each graduate are being taken up close by a professional photographer, and all grads will also be visible on the Jumbotron as they cross the stage. Today's ceremony is being live streamed and recorded. The recordings will be made public on the SCUSD website. Thank you for your assistance in making this a wonderful experience for everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Adelaide. Greetings, McClatchy graduate candidates, and welcome to our families and friends who have gathered here today to celebrate all of you. I'm Andrea Egan, and I am your very proud principal. It's been my sincere pleasure to support you at CKM, the home of the Lions Pride. It's a great day to be a Lion. I'd like to introduce the folks on the stage who are here to share in your day of celebration. Our superintendent, Mr. Jorge Aguilar, our area board trustee, Ms. Tara Jean, and I want to acknowledge the class of 2023 class sponsors, Mrs. Tammy Abdo and Sergeant Chris Taylor. Thank you both for being here to share in this incredible display of achievement. Before I move on, I want to acknowledge three important people who are retiring at the end of this school year. Would Mrs. Mago, Mr. Gatton, and Mrs. Wong please stand wherever you are? Spanish teacher Maria Mago, English teacher Dan Gatton, and social science teacher and humanities and international studies coordinator Ellen Wong have a combined 89 years of teaching service in Sac City Unified. I wish them all the best in their well-earned retirement and thank them for their incredible service and influence on our community. As I thought about what to say to our graduates today, I started out my first draft listing all the hardships and hurdles you've all had to overcome due to the pandemic landing amidst your high school experience. These challenges are undeniable, and many special moments were missed. The class of 2023 did not have the full luxury of all the typical high school milestones as you spent a year zooming through school. Yet today, you would never know that given the incredible school spirit you ended with over the course of this last year. Homecoming alone was a spectacle of absolute joy and McClatchy pride we have not felt at full scale in many years. As our football team beat Kennedy in the Big Cat Classic, led by team captains Cook, Lewis, Godbout, Espinosa, and Wasser. Speaking of athletics, we took Metro League titles in boys water polo, girls golf, girls volleyball, girls and boys cross country, girls tennis, boys swim, baseball, girls water polo, girls basketball, girls soccer, and boys soccer. We watched our Lady Lion varsity basketballers and our girls varsity soccer stars go to the state playoff level. We sent runners McNatt, and Redmond all the way to the state meet where they made us and their families proud. You had other exciting moments this year, like the return of art immersion, where we all saw your fine art senior exhibits. We also enjoyed the combined band and orchestra's momentous spring concert that was later reassembled for audience in Spain and Portugal. I'm still shook up from the spring musical, and fans are swooning for Phelan and the show's cast. Radio operators, in our Criminal Justice Academy reached around the world contacting an operator in Yokohama, Japan. You started and reinvigorated inclusive, diverse, and exciting clubs as a class. Our BSU leaders dreamed up and hosted a 90s dance. The first ever El Baile with a live band was organized by La Raza Colectiva and Hispavix, which restored energy to our cultural clubs and brought community members together. There are countless personal academic achievements to be acknowledged and celebrated this year. Almost 300 of you earned a 3.0 GPA or above, as seen in many graduate silver and gold medals today. Over 200 of you earned the Golden State Seal Merit Award, which will be affixed to your diplomas, and 70 of you received the State Seal of Biliteracy Honor, which is visible in the white cord students wearing today. A dozen of you earned the State Seal of Civic Engagement, which is seen today on graduates wearing a metallic and crystal colored medal. As you all prepare to leave the iconic red and white hallways of CKM to start your adult lives in varied ways with admissions at City College, new jobs in the workforce, enlistments in the United States military, and college starts at UCs, CSUs, and Ivy Leagues, I hope McClatchy has prepared you for success with knowledge in literature, mathematics, science, history, the arts, and athletics. But maybe most of all, I hope we filled you with a sense of community in your formative years. Remember, once a lion, always a lion. I'd like to now introduce our Associated Student Body President, Eli Ayton. He will serve as our MC for our ceremony today.
Thank you, Principal Egan. I would like to welcome to the podium our Sac City Unified School District Superintendent, Jorge Aguilar.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias a todos. I want to, first of all, start by sending my congratulations to the C.K. McClatchy High School class. I want to acknowledge staff. Job to prepare because of their tireless work. This class can proudly celebrate high school experience for this graduating class. You've persevered through it all and achieved this important milestone. Today should not be seen as an ending, but as one of many memorable achievements. And personal growth. The confidence to set high expectations for yourself, but do not let failure deter you from goals. Down. As you look into the audience and short time for their love and support, no matter how it was expressed. My hope for you is that you will take the knowledge you have acquired today and apply it going forward, no matter what you choose to do in your futures. I can tell you that at my age, the speed of your life is about to accelerate in ways you cannot fully understand right now. Years that once felt like lifetimes will soon whiz past you in a matter of seconds. So I encourage you to bask in the moment, appreciate what it means and what it took to get here. And finally, I hope that each of you reach a point in your lives where you can, as one of my favorite wrote, the sun corrects my accomplishment. It's an honor to be celebrating with you.
Thank you, Superintendent Aguilar. I'd like to next welcome our SUSD trustee for Area 1, Tara G.
Hello, class of 2023. For my speech as a trustee, but ultimately, just like AI, no one has this figured out. Your goal in life is to figure you out, figure out what you want, and have a lot of fun meeting the people along the way that you get to figure it out with. Those that become our best friends, those that challenge us, because ultimately, the original experience you've had in high school gives me hope create in the world you're entering into. Congratulations.
Thank you, Trustee Jean. I'd like to next welcome our first commencement speaker, Salome Gatahun.
Good morning, family, friends, faculty, and peers. Before person gathered here to celebrate the accomplishments of class of 23. Without your love and support, none of us would have made it this far. As I stand here today, I'm overwhelmed with feelings of joy and relief, along with an underlying sense of worry for the future I'm sure many of us graduating seniors can attest to. We are about to embark on a new chapter of our lives, and as challenging as that is, we must cling to the virtues we have developed throughout our high school experience. Kindness, perseverance, confidence, and countless other attributes are evident in our class. I cannot We are the manifestation of hard work pays off, and everyone who made it here should feel immensely proud of themselves. I remember my first days at McClatchy, and like all the other freshmen, I was intimidated by its large student body population, attempting to navigate my way around campus, and overall struggling to adjust to such a new environment. Nonetheless, we have clearly overcome that struggle, and as a class that managed to combat the pandemic at only 14 and 15 years old, it is safe to say we will overcome any other future barriers and obstacles. And extracurricular endeavors. I've loved my time here and would not trade the lessons I've learned and people I've connected with for anything. I've met amazing teachers who went above and beyond for me and asked nothing in return, experienced the support of a community that truly believed in me, and embodied what it means. One thing I will always appreciate about CKM is our special to my 4 years of upbringing, education, and most importantly, preparation to embark on a world of unknowns and adulthood. Our exposure to diversity in our student body has enabled us to acknowledge differences in financial status, race, sexual orientation, religion, and more, but nonetheless unite as class of 23. That being said, if there is one thing I've learned here, I hope it is that society has a long way to go, but remains in our hands. Whether this means voting or being actively engaged in our communities and politics, our social involvement and unity as young adults holds so much power. Looking at the vast potential that surrounds me each day, it would be disappointing if we were not to lead meaningful lives. Everybody's path looks different, but going forward, we can each make something of ourselves, leave a legacy, and strive to do our very best. We only live once, and we each owe it to ourselves, each other, and future generations to go out and change the world as McClatchy has prepared us to do. So, class of 23, let's go on to spread love and awareness, treat others equally with an understanding of their background and struggles, broaden our perspectives, enter adulthood as socially aware, compassionate individuals, and exemplify the change we want to see in the world. Today, like all days, I can say with full confidence, it's a great day to be a Lion.
Thank you, Salome. I'd like to welcome our next commencement speaker, Will Monnet.
Good morning, everyone, and siblings and friends. I hope the sun is treating you better than it's treating the rest of us. Good morning, faculty, hiding down in the dugouts, I see, and good morning, graduates. I must admit that I don't know very many of you, and so first off, I'd like to say hi. My name is Will, and it's a pleasure to meet you all. Writing this kind of speech is not easy. It's easy to say thank you to the school and to parents and teachers, but it's really hard to say something that's meaningful to us, the seniors. All of us come from different backgrounds and perspectives, and this graduation means something just a little bit different to everyone. And that's good for a number of reasons, but most importantly, it means that each of us is unique. Being unique, especially right now, is really, really important. A lot of pressure is put on us to be better. Complete with both flaws and gifts. Now, I was going to say something here about how we still remain unique even through COVID, but honestly, I don't think we need to hear any of that. We lived it, and there's no need to talk about it more than we absolutely have to. Instead, I'd like to tell you about a little comparison that my first period teacher, Mr. Griffin, once told my psychology class. Way back at the beginning of the year, the school year covered in leaves, and then fall and winter, the leaves fall off. By the time they come back in the spring, I never really thought about it very much until recently. And I think that it makes even more sense than he knows. You see, we start our senior year attached to the tree, attached to the school. For the most part, we're basically still just juniors. And as the years go on, we start to fall away. Figured out, we all come back, and the tree has leaves again. It's the last time we'll be together. It's the last time we'll have our parents and friends and teachers around us in the capacity that they are now. It's the last time we'll be in high school. And after the summer, the leaves all blow away again. Some land very close to the tree. Some will land very, very far away. most will be picked up by the wind and blown again. But amidst all the other leaves we may find ourselves among, we all know that we came from the same tree. It's not going to be easy, but if it was easy, it wouldn't be worth it. So before we set out into this next chapter of our lives, you could say that as of this moment, we're turning over a new leaf. Thank you.
Thank you, Will. If you and everyone would turn your attention to the first base dugout, we have a musical performance by Aaron Allen and our C.K. McClatchy Jazz Ensemble. They perform Feeling Good. Thank you. please give it up once again for Aaron Allen and our jazz band. I'd like to next welcome.
Hello, everyone. When I was very young, I think of this phrase, we take a little step into adulthood. Those who we grew up inside and experience this unique time together. But leaving is not forever, for we will meet each other again.
Yes.
Whether it was our parents,
friends, or teachers, we could have not done it without their support. Someone believed in us, helped shape us to be functioning human beings, how to make goals, and how to achieve them, and supported us through abandoning Plan A and taught us how to move on to Plan B. I am here today because of our family, but most specifically my grandparents, Roberta and Daniel Oluchi. Their selfless acts of kindness led me to this moment. They moved all the way to Sacramento to be a part of my childhood. They drove me to school every day from first through sixth grades, would listen to my piano practices, help me through my homework, and so much more. On top of these essential after school outside my classes, so I wouldn't have to walk alone, sing to me in the car, take me ice cream every Thursday, and leave my ice cream so I could just eat it home, because it is the best part. Most importantly, they taught me to spend time with the people I love. What I say affects others, and to always be grateful for what I have. These deeds, on top of driving me to school, have helped me succeed, not only in my education, but through my daily life. Our lives are only as the power of the connections around us. Our lives, quite literally, are our people, our inner circles, our families, both chosen and biological. No amount of time you spend with someone can determine how their actions can affect you. It can be a simple smile in the hallway, those conversations you have with people in your classes that you normally not talk to, your best friend whom you can talk to for hours on FaceTime, or that teacher who is passionate about their work, making you passionate about the subject. We are all meant to take all the relationships we have had with each other, no matter if they have lasted 10 years or 10 days, no amount of time can determine if someone makes an impression on our lives. Throughout this monumental moment, I want you all to think of all the people who helped you get here today. Acknowledge the efforts they made for you. If they are here today, thank them. If that's someone for donating their time to take you to school, for teaching you how to multiply, for teaching you how to use your imagination on the playground. If they are unable to be here with us today, or if you lost someone, remember them. Thank those who supported you through every decision. Thank those who stood as barriers for they motivated you to work harder. Above all, thank yourself for always being there for you, for not giving up and being a vessel in which you can make all these relationships with people who help build you as a person. Through this community in high school, we have helped develop each other's identity and knowledge of ourselves. In this incredibly unique class of 2023, we have a connection that is different from anything else you will experience. We genuinely wish the best for everyone and wish for everyone to succeed in their future. The phrase, "Ahuiho," is used to maintain a feeling of hope. We will always find our way back to each other. It may be next week seeing each other at the grocery store, in 2 months at the same university, in 10 years at a high school reunion, on a flight back to Sacramento to visit our roots. We are meant to take all the relationships we have had with each other. No matter if they lasted 10 years or 10 days, no amount of time can determine how someone makes an impression on our lives. I implore you all to be open to making new relationships, to take risks, to make mistakes and learn from them, and remember those who have helped you to succeed and express gratitude towards them. Thank yourself, for you could have not made it without you. To my fellow class of 2023, ahuiho, until we meet again.
Thank you, Olivia.
Ethan Machado. Faculty, administrators, parents, family, and friends, and most importantly, my fellow graduates, good morning and congratulations to the C.K. McClatchy class of 2023. Now, when I found out I'd be speaking at this graduation, I decided to prepare with the same intensity and fervor many of us have devoted into some of our assignments over the past 4 years. So late last night, I began writing. Precisely in our lowest moments, when doubt and insecurity plague our thoughts, that we each maintain the ability to move forward and grow stronger and kinder as human beings. Graduates, there will be times when things don't go our way, when we bomb a final, when we don't get the job we want, or when the girl we like plans to study on the other side of the country. In these moments, when ambiguity plagues our academic, professional, and personal lives, rather than fear, uncertainty, and let it fester, I implore you to embrace it as an opportunity for growth and a chance to chart a new course. As we have seen throughout our time at CKM, it is in the face of the unknown that we discover our true potential to weather any setback. It is during these times of uncertainty that we learn to be adaptable, resourceful, and resilient. An ever-changing world will never stop throwing obstacles in our way. However, if we're willing to take risks, step out of our comfort zones, and embrace the unexpected, we can better manage the course we take in our future. Now, if you've tuned me on for the past couple minutes, that is fine, but please heed this. I urge you to have the courage to face the unknown with the same wide-eyed enthusiasm we had when we started this journey 4 years ago. Embrace the uncertainty of your chosen class and stay true to your passion, even if they diverge from the norm. These uncharted territories are where groundbreaking discoveries are made, innovative ideas are born, and new discoveries are made, be they monumental to mankind or monumental personally. Let us also redefine what it means to be successful, making it less about our accomplishments and more about our ability to rise up after each setback and keep moving forward. Remember, Together, we can navigate the uncharted waters of our future and seize every opportunity that lies on the horizon. Once again, congratulations, Lions, and thank you for an unforgettable 4 years.
All right, let's give our speakers and our musical performers one more round of applause. I know it's been a four-year class. You guys can come on down. All right, we're going to get ourselves reset here. And it is just about time. Thank you.
have the diploma in being here.
Natalie Garcia. Natalie Sertel Martinez.
Milan.
Alexander, you remain. Elijah.
Cheers.